Good evening, I'd like to call to order the Ward County Commissioners, and we do have forum, we've got all the commissioners here tonight. First item on the agenda is, or first item tonight is pledge of allegiance and indication, and I'll turn it over to Chris Green. Chris, you lead the witness.
Stand, pledge the flag for the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, we come to you tonight, just thankful hearts, thank you for all the many blessings that you did pour out on us. We know that all that we have comes from you. We thank you for friends and family and neighbors that have turned aside to gather here. Lord, we thank you for the freedom that we have to gather and assemble, open. Thank you for the freedom that we have to call your name here in this place. We thank you for those that have given ultimate sacrifice to protect those freedoms and those that continue to be in harm's way. Lord, we ask your guidance for this body that's gathered here tonight for the decisions that they make. Ask that you grant them the wisdom and discernment so that they will do what is pleasing to you. Lord, all this we continue to ask in your name.
I'd like to recognize any elected officials that are here tonight. Representing that if you're elected official, would you please stand and be recognized? Would like to recognize, she's not elected, but well, she is elected in her position, but Vicki Paginer, she's the chair of our Chamber of Commerce, so appreciate you being here tonight. Any veterans that are here, if you would please stand and so we can recognize you. We have several county department heads tonight. If you would please stand and just let us know your name and which department you're with.
Allison Moody, Human Resources.
Brian Heffley, Finance.
Chris Green, Tax Administration.
Bill McCarty, Planning.
Thank you. Commissioners, first item on the agenda tonight is to adopt the proposed agenda. Entertain a motion unless there's a change we need to make on the agenda.
So moved.
Got a motion approved?
Second.
And a second, thank you. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Thank you. Next item on the agenda is citizen recognition. Person wishing to appear before the commission during this portion of the meeting should register their name and the subject they wish to address with the county clerk prior to the beginning of the meeting. Each presentation will be limited to 3 minutes. More time is needed, please register your request to be placed on the agenda of the next regular meeting with the county clerk. Tonight we have 4 people signed up for citizen recognition, and the first one is Stan Joyner. If you please come up, state your name and address, please.
My name is Stan Joyner. I live at 729 Canterbury Road in Houston. I'd like to talk a minute to, first of all, I'd like to thank you, commissioners, for what you do. I think I'd be a nervous wreck if I tried to do what you do. Not just the election part of it, you might not win or not, but once you see it, I'm sure you get bombarded with requests for department heads and people are asking for things. And usually it involves money. And you say, where's it going to come from? Well, we don't want to raise taxes. You got, what are we going to do? So I'm sure it's very tempting when you have something like a casino come along and say, we'd be glad to pay taxes. We're glad to buy utilities. We'd be glad to be a quote good citizens of this county. But I would remind you that casinos don't make anything. They don't produce leases. They don't sell shoes. Not what I call legitimate even service in the industry like a bank. They're actually just moving money from people from one person to another. Taking money from a lot of people and giving a lot to a few. And then, of course, the American Act and send a few other customers to the so I encourage you to, as you think about this, and I appreciate you being representatives, as you, the burden falls on you to do the homework, to look and see what's going to happen if the casino does come to Kings Mountain, Cleveland County. Because if it comes, we'll never be the same again. So So I just encourage you, thank you for your efforts and your work, and encourage you to take that very seriously. I'm sure you do. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Next, we have Mr. Buford Burton. Please come up. Say your name and address, please.
I'm Buford Burton. I reside at 322 Margrave Road in Keys, Miami. Chairman and commissioners, you've heard representatives of the Keys, Miami Awareness Group ask you multiple times to hear evidence of the devastation that the casino can bring to Cleveland County, and yet you refuse the opportunity. You've been remarkably quiet on the subject, and no one knows if you've even considered the voices speaking out against the casino. Because of your unwillingness to listen, you have, metaphorically speaking, held us in captivity. We're prisoners being held against our will and silenced by the insulated wall you put between us. You're somewhat like the Pharaoh of Egypt being unwilling to listen to Moses. Your hearts have been hardened. How many times do you have to hear people things come to our county before you're willing to listen and truly represent us in the legal? It's been months since the suffering today to withdraw your support of the casino again. And you must hear that by withdrawing, you can only be correcting a wrongdoing on your part. Yes, I'm talking about you signing a letter on behalf of the citizens of Cleveland County. But you really had no idea how many supported it. The letter appeared to be a consensus of the board, but it only represents your individual opinions simply because of the sentence that says on behalf of the citizens. That statement is true, but it's also illogical. It would be more accurate if the letter had said the Catawba and the casino have my support for each one of you. In my view, no amount of kindness towards you, attempts at understanding or sugarcoating this issue matters any longer. It's time you recognize the swell of discontent with your initial decision to sign the letter and your current refusal to correct the mistake. Admittedly, your withdrawal of support may not stop the casino from coming here, but it will say to the citizens who elected you that you are willing to listen to reason and study both sides of the issue, and most of all, that you listen to the citizens you represent. Once again, I ask you to withdraw your support, especially that claimed support on behalf of the citizens of Cleveland County that you clearly do not have. If you insist on staying the course of your own personal support, then at least write a letter saying the support is perfect and does not necessarily represent the majority of the citizens of Cleveland County. I'm going to give you one Bible verse here just to consider. It's out of 2 Peter chapter 2. But there were also false prophets among the people, even as there will be false teachers among you, who will secretly bring in destructive heresies, even denying the Lord who brought them, and bring on themselves swift destruction. Thank you.
Next on the agenda, we have, or next on the list, we have Ms. Cynthia Forcade. State your name and address, please.
Board of Commissioners, thank you for your attention. Tonight, I want to pose some questions for your consideration and read to you excerpts from the documentary video, Pushing Blood. Do you want a business that preys on problem gamblers? Do you want local citizens working in jobs that target the vulnerable? This story is related by a top casino employee. He received a call from a lady who kept receiving mail solicitation from the casino. She said, "Would you stop? Stop sending me these mail pieces. My husband's dead. He's gone. You destroyed him. Just leave me alone. You guys keep sending this. It's already hard enough. Just stop." The employee relates that it was his job to develop players. That's the continuous cycle, he says. Developing players, watching them lose money, and then you hear about the divorce, you hear about the suicide. Then another person comes and you do it all over again. That's the cycle, over and over. developing that player. I looked over maybe tens of thousands of accounts. There is a column with the lifetime loss, showing the amount of money that the player lost. How can you recover from an accumulated nest egg that you saved for 10, 20, 30, 40 years, and you lost it in a month, 2 months, a year? How do you rebound from that? You just play another dollar. Commissioners, do you want to look back in 5 to 10 years and regret your decision County? Here's another excerpt from one of your colleagues, Frank Nero, former New Jersey County Commissioner. I was supportive of casino gambling in Atlantic City because I felt it could provide a catalyst to revitalize this once great resort area in the state of New Jersey. If I knew then what I know now, clearly I would not have supported it. When I look back at what happened, and more accurately, what did not happen, the promises never came to fruition. The revitalization of Atlantic City never came. At first, businesses were excited about the potential growth. It didn't take a lot of time to figure out it was actually hurting their businesses. Casinos are masters at sucking people in and keeping them there and then sending them home. Do you really want a casino-driven local economy? As small businesses disappear, as restaurants go out of business, and other businesses can't compete, what you have is a casino-driven local economy. Then you're really in a bind. Then what you have to do is support the one big industry in town, which is the casino, which continues to extract wealth from the community until it's a downward spiral. The casino employee's job is to keep the player in this rat race, to keep them here as long as you can. There is no partnership with other business. The casino is meant to be the hub. Thank you.
Okay. State your name and address, please.
Adam Forkay, 1005 Serenity Woods, Bessemer City, 7.1 miles from ground zero. Commissioners, thank you for the opportunity to address the commission tonight. I'd like to address two principles that all elected officials should have firmly in their command. Elected officials have many cares, concerns, and responsibilities. Luckily, the citizens of Cleveland County have an elected board of commissioners that have done a fine job for the most part in carrying out these duties. However, as regards the current casino dilemma, my group feels that two areas in particular could use an examination and hopefully a rededication on your part to return to good leadership. I'll start with stewardship. Merriam says that stewardship is the conducting, supervising, or managing of something, especially the careful and responsible management of something entrusted to one's care. One could say that each of you are stewards to the citizens of the county. Gathering information is perhaps the most critical component of effective management. You as a board have self-admittedly considered the barest minimum of information regarding a casino's impact, and only that presented by those who will profit by its presence. In perhaps a more egregious lack of vision, you have also declined to have additional information presented to you in any format other than what I can squeeze in here during a 3-minute time slot twice a month. How is this careful and responsible management of something we have entrusted to you? Excuse me. The other area of your position that we feel is lacking on this issue is representation. Again, consulting Merriam, we find this. The body of persons representing a constituency. The substitution of an individual in place of a person or a class. In order to fairly represent the county on any given issue, one might have to know what a majority of those constituents wanted you to do. We do not feel this principle has been achieved on this issue. Mr. Hutchins mentioned in a newspaper interview that everyone he has spoken with wants a casino. Mr. Deer said in a television interview that he has spoken to nobody who opposes a casino. A quick non-scientific experiment on our social media sites revealed that for better than 700 county residents, only 8 of them have been approached by one of you on this subject. Do any of you consider 8 to be a majority of 700? Can you as a board tell us that you have collectively spoken to even 500 people? Far more telling would be for you to disclose how many people you spoke to prior to signing a letter that stated, we as citizens welcome and want a casino in our community. In closing, how can you represent us if you don't take the time and effort to find out what we want you to do? How can you tell us that you are taking good care of that which we have entrusted to you when you have failed to gather enough information to make an educated and considered decision? We ask you to retract your letter of support until such time as you are able to say that you have examined all research on the subject, as well as consulted the majority of the people you represent on what their wishes are. Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioners, next on the agenda, we have a consent agenda, and for that, I'll turn it over to our county manager.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Members of the board, tonight, several items for your consideration. Under our consent agenda, item A is the minutes from the May 6th, 2014 regular meeting for your review consideration decision, please. Item B, under tax administration, would be our May collection report. And for the month of May, our tax collections reflect 97.44% collected year to date. And this is equitably in line with what was collected last year at this time. Item C, also in tax administration, have to do with our tax abatements and supplements for May of 2014. We have abatements in the amount of $3,726.07, and we have supplements in the amount of $39,756.26. Our next item, item D, is budget amendment number 66, and it is from the LeBrand Center in the amount of $49,239. And this will allow our city finance, our county finance department to budget unbudgeted revenues that will be used for a new software purchase. Next item for consideration, item E, is the Juvenile Crime Prevention Council annual funding allocation plan. I would highlight for the board, and I know you've taken a look at this, there are no direct costs to Cleveland County. This plan was completed by the Juvenile Crime Prevention Council to identify gaps in services through a juvenile risk and needs assessment. And as I stated earlier, the plan has been included in your agenda packet this evening. Finally, board, item F is from our Human Resources Department, and this would be a personnel ordinance change for your consideration. Our Human Resources Department is requesting to change the personnel ordinance related to retiree insurance. Our current plan, as it's stated, allows employees who have worked with Cleveland County for at least 20 years to receive health insurance at no cost until they are Medicare eligible. If you were to approve the change this evening, as of July the 1st, all new employees hired on or after July 1st upon retirement would be required to obtain their own health insurance. And I would reiterate to the board that this change would only affect newly hired employees hired after July 1st, 2014. Members of the board, if you've got any specific questions about any of your consent agenda items, staff is certainly available to answer any questions that you may have. Mr. Chair, with that, I'll turn it back over to you.
Commissioners, you've heard this consent agenda. Is there any discussion? I'll entertain a motion.
I move, Mr. Chair.
A motion. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Got a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your hand. Thank you. Next on the agenda is under regular agenda, planning department. And Bill, can I ask you to come up? And how's it going, Bobby?
We received a complaint on this property back in October.
notify the property owner, and she was, had moved away, was not aware that it was in that condition, and wanted us to wait to take care of it. So we are here before you tonight to adopt an ordinance to demolish the home, and we will notify her of the cost of that. We'll, of course, bid it out, make bids. What can be recycled will be subtracted or deducted from the cost of demolition. So I'll be glad to answer any questions.
Commissioners, any questions for the bill?
Move to approve the ordinance, Mr. Chairman.
Got a motion on the floor? Is there a second?
I'll second, but I got a question.
Got a second. Now we'll open up for discussion, please.
Okay.
Does the landowner own this?
Yes.
Right.
Okay.
So that would put the link on.
Yes. If they choose not to pay, then
yeah,
would get that property. I hope they'll pay the bill.
And these ordinance is only driven by complaints.
Correct.
Any other questions for Bill? All right.
I have one, Mr. Chairman, if I may.
Sure.
After you finish this.
Okay. Sure. All right. I've got a motion and a second. You want to have to vote? Is that what you're... You want to discuss before I have to vote? Is that correct?
No, sir. I won't ask you about another project.
Okay. Okay. Hold on a second. Got a motion and a second on this one. No other discussion. All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
Thank you.
Bill, if you call for second.
If I may.
Sure.
Go ahead. After last meeting, we had discussed an issue that had come before this board for several years, and we were just talking about it abandoned, and I just want to see if Bill actually checked into it.
Yeah, the back end of your hand when you left. The one I had in my hand when we left was patched. And I don't believe that's the one you were thinking of. You were thinking of Mac. And I have not been by that one.
Can you get that on the agenda?
I can.
If all right, Mr. Chairman.
Sure. Yep. Any other discussion? All right. Thank you, Bill. Appreciate it. Next item on the agenda is lease agreement between Cleveland County and Cleveland County School System. On Pat Drive, I'll turn that over to our county manager, Jeff Richards.
Mr. Chair, thank you. I'll remain seated, and just if it's good with the board, I'll just cover the overview of the lease agreement and the opportunity that Cleveland County government has. The Cleveland County Board of Education, upon the request from county government, has formally agreed to lease the Instructional Center, which is located at 315 Patton Drive, and the former Hunter School, which is located close proximity at 403 Pickney Street, for a lease price of $1 per year for a period of up to 7 years. A little bit of background is that the Board of Education no longer occupies the adjoining Instructional Center or the former Hunter School properties located at the street addresses that I formally gave you. The Instructional Center is an existing office building. It's two floors, a main floor and a basement. It's got 5,056 square feet on the main floor, and it's identical in the basement, finished basement level. It was most recently used for offices and for training. Paved parking to the north and to the side, and the land is about an acre and a half. The building was built in 1979, and the property was appraised as is for $572,000 last year. The old Hunter School is an office storage building, originally built in 1940 as a public school. Cleveland County government is currently utilizing a portion of the building for storage of county museum archives, and that's on a handshake agreement with our county school system, and they've been very cordial to allow us to use that for that storage, and it's worked out very well for us over the last several years. The building contains 13,084 square feet. There's paved parking and a secured fenced vehicle and equipment storage area on two sides of the property. And the property was also appraised in 2013 at $155,000. And for continued operational usage, the building needs a roof replacement which is about $23,000, and probably some upgrades with windows and air conditioning and HVAC heating. The staff sees a number of pros to this potential lease agreement to allow the county to go in for a period of 7 years at $1 a year and occupy both the instructional center along with the Hunter School for storage. It frees the county up to address some immediate space and operating needs, both at the law enforcement center and with our court system, including adult and juvenile probation. It's a site that is a very strategic site as it relates to the proximity to the core of downtown where our law enforcement center and our administrative offices are. And the site has got a lot of capacity. It's secure, and staff is very excited about the opportunity to occupy this site up to a 7-year period to determine highest and best use. And hopefully, if it works out well, at the 7-year mark, we have an opportunity to purchase this first right of refusal, and the purchase price will be driven by the county commissioners and the Board of Education coming to an agreeable sales price. If another deal is not reached prior to that 7-year period. Be happy to answer any questions that you've got. This consideration is for you this evening, and I'm certainly happy to answer any questions that I've not covered. And Mr. Chair, I'll turn it back over to you.
Any questions about the lease agreement?
Mr. Chairman, I can't wait to see the document.
Our councilman's got, that's why his win. But also the legal counsel for the school system is also in the
council. I guess this is very technical. In the event we choose to purchase the building in the 7 years, that money goes to construction of the new school site.
That's a good point, Mr. Chair. You may want to
address that. Capital needs. Any other questions for our county manager?
I have no further questions. Make a motion. We do the lease.
Got a motion and a second. Thank you. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Thank you. Now down to board appointments. And Terry, can I turn this over to you?
You can.
On the board appointments, there's quite a few of them tonight.
Okay, the first board I bring before you tonight is the Adult Care Home Advisory Committee. For the public's sake, this is a board that we're always looking for people to serve on. So if you or know of anybody who may be interested in serving on this committee, it's a very important committee that goes out to the community and looks at our adult care homes. I bring before you six citizens who are currently serving on this committee and would like to be reappointed as their active members. They would serve a 3-year term to expire June of 2017.
I make a motion to reappoint the six because we have can't make up the 10. Yeah. Make a motion to reappoint the six.
Got a motion to appoint. Reappoint. And a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
The next board I bring before you is the Agriculture Advisory Board. This board does require that all its members are involved in agriculture production, and it's also a requirement that they be recommended by either Soil and Water Conservation or Farm Bureau. I bring before you tonight two citizens, Michael Underwood and Randy Cook, for a 3-year term, which would expire again in June of 2017.
Commissioners, are there any questions?
I can only report the two since we do have three appointments.
Got a motion to appoint the two that are listed?
No, second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
The next board is the Child Fatality Prevention Team. We have one member whose term expires this June. It's Dr. Leslie Richardson, who currently serves as the chairman of this board. The appointment for this position is for 3 years, which would expire in June 2017.
Mr. Blake, got a motion approved. Is there a second?
Second.
Got a second. All those in favor, any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Thank you.
Next board I bring to you is the Commission for Women. Currently, there are 6 members of that board whose terms are expiring at the end of June. These members are also all active members of the board. Kay Wallace, Robert Miller, Al Finney, Joyce Morrow Coleman, Deborah Blanton, and Esther Plummer. They would also serve 3-year terms, which would expire in June of 2017.
Commissioners, you've heard the names. What's your pleasure? Got a motion to approve. Is there a second? Got a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
Next board I bring to you is the Cleveland Community College Board of Trustees. You have an entire list of citizens who have expressed interest in serving on this board. There's one vacancy, which has been filled for the short term by Commissioner Hutchins. The term is for 4 years, which would expire in June of 2018.
I'll make a motion to appoint Westmore to fill that position.
I've got a motion. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Got a second. A third, it sounds like. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Thank you. Before you go on the next one, I'd like to publicly thank Commissioner Hutchins for filling in on that board and got us out of it was very sad that we lost one of our members, but appreciate you doing that for us.
Next board I bring to you is the Isothermal Planning and Development Commission. There is one member, Bobby Rogers, whose term is expiring. I have a whole list before you. Mr. Rogers has expressed his interest in being reappointed to this board. It would be for a 3-year term, again, which would expire in June 2017.
I'll make a motion to reappoint Bobby Rogers.
Got a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Got a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
The next board I bring to you is the Juvenile Crime Prevention Council. This board list was actually included as part of their annual plan. This board requires its members to have really specific job titles or responsibilities. So you have a list before you. It's over that served for 2-year terms, which would expire in June 2016.
Commissioners, you have a list before you. What's your pleasure? We can appoint all these. All of them on the list. Got a motion approved?
Second.
I have a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your hand. Thank you.
The next board I bring to you is the Cleveland Memorial Library Board. This is another one where we have had some task of trying to find members. So again, if you know of anybody who might be interested in serving on this board, please contact me or April. But I bring before you Tucker Hopper as a possible appointment to serve a 3-year term, again, which would expire in June of 2017.
Commissioners, your pleasure? Got a motion to approve. Is there a second?
Second.
Got a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your hand.
The next board I bring before you is the number 3 Volunteer Fire Department Fire Protection District Board. The members of this board must live in the community. We do have one, unfortunately, Bobby Biggers has been a member of that board for a long time. He recently passed away. So I bring before you David Austin, Neil Strick, and James Gibson as appointments to this board. They're 2-year terms, which would expire in June 2016.
All three. Commissioners, your pleasure?
Approved.
Got a motion approved. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Got a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Thank you.
The next board I bring to you is the Social Services Board. Currently, Betsy Wells is your appointment to that board. Her term expires at the end of this month. She is currently serving as chairperson for that board. So the Department of Social Services would like her to be reappointed if possible, but it would be a 3-year term, again, which would expire in June of 2017.
Got a motion to approve. Is there a second?
Second.
Got a second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
next board I bring to you is the Nursing Home Advisory Committee. This is another one of our boards where we're having trouble getting members to serve on. So we have actually four vacancies, but I bring two folks before you tonight who are currently active members of this board, Judy Barrett and Elaine Champion, and ask that they be reappointed to a 3-year term.
I make a motion to reappoint. Is there a second? Got a second?
Second.
Commissioner Holbrook, second. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
The next board I bring to you is the Personnel Advisory Committee Board. These are actual county employees who serve on this board. I bring before you three employees, Chris Martin, Wayne Brown, and Sherry Gear. Fortunately, these members have been on this board for a 1-year term, but they have never had to listen to a case. So we're asking that they be reappointed for another 1-year term, which would expire June next year.
Got a motion to approve? There's a second.
Yeah.
And a second. Commissioner Holbrook. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
The next board I bring before you is the Rural Fire Commission. This group is tasked with visiting our volunteer fire departments once a year to check that all the rules are being followed. We have five members who currently serve on this board, who are active members of this board. If it's your pleasure, they would be reappointed for a 3-year term, which would expire in June of 2017.
I'll make the motion to reappoint.
Got a motion to reappoint?
Second.
And a second. Thank you. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
Two more. The next board is the Employee Productivity Board. This board actually reviews our Employee Productivity Award once a year for our Employee Appreciation Day. Michael Krishan had served on that board for some time. We're asking now that commissioners appoint Audrey Wetton, who is the Uptown Shelby Association Executive Director, I think she's called, to serve on this board. It would be a 1-year term, so it would expire in June of next year.
Questions? Got a motion approved?
Second.
And a second. Thank you. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand.
Thank you.
Michael.
It's the last one. I bring before you the Veterans Council. This is one where we, again, we're short one member. So if anybody from the public knows of anybody or who's interested in serving on this board, please let me know. But I do bring before you Kenneth Ledford for appointment to a 3-year term, which would expire in June of 2017.
Commissioners.
Got
a motion to appoint and a second. Thank you. Any other discussion? All those in favor, please raise your right hand. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I may.
Yes, sir.
Veterans Council. I've heard numerous veterans give respect to this board. One, get in the Veterans Office House basement. Two, the board adding extra support. And three, for the services. Carol, new to our veterans. I have heard many, many horror stories from other counties that do not attend to the veterans like we do. And I would just say if we could give our staff and county manager to go by and thank Carol and Devlin for all the hard work they do. You know, my role, I meet with a lot of the spouses. My firm continues to follow what the paperwork wants to mediate a lot of work that they did. But all I ever hear is praise that come back from the spouses about how Carol and Deborah have helped them along. And I'm, myself and Johnny, I know, have been to jail. And you're a veteran also, but Jane is aged. They need to help the two of us. I'm aged out, I'm talking about Johnny more than I am. But this county actually stands out as doing more for veterans than most counties in the state. And it is because of this board and their foresight and looking at our veterans, and it is the right personnel that we have that, I guess Carol learned on her own the hard way, Carol teaching Deborah, but I have not heard one negative that has come out of anyone that has not been served by our office.
I'll make sure that county manager does relay.
One thing that council needs to know too is that a lot of people think that when they come up here as a veterans council, that the United States government is paying those positions. Not useful. We are. It's part of the county. Citizens of the county are paying to serve our veterans. And if we could just give them thanks for what they did.
Thank you,
Chair. I'd like to follow up on that and say Carol does a wonderful job. It's really noticed by a lot of people, other than just the people in this county. She's gracious enough to man a site during the American Legion World Series on the concourse. And I've had numerous people from across the country, particularly veterans, comment like Commissioner Hawkins just said, they can't believe that our county has a person who's willing to sit out there and accommodate the veterans during the series. It's noticed by a lot of folks.
She's got a big heart, and she's got a big heart for veterans. And it's one of those that I honestly believe it's like a ministry to her. She does it for the right reason, and she does
it. She may be around to get a little too.
Well, she my dad's a veteran as well, and my dad went to visit her 2 weeks ago. He told me after he went up there, and she was very helpful to him as well. So that is, Gary is correct that we do have some boards that we just don't have a lot of people applying for. So if anyone knows of anyone that would like to serve on a board or committee, they can go on our county website. There's an application that you can fill out online. You can specify which board that you'd be interested in serving on, and that information will come back to us. We do have some county training that you go through to serve on a board, but Veterans Council is, we're shorthanded. We've got one position open right there. I know some of the other ones have positions as well, so it really would be appreciated. Okay. With that, we're down to commissioners' reports. And I can start over. Commissioner Hawkins, we'll start with you.
I'm going to add to this. I want to thank you. I want to thank you for your effort in trying to get the community breakfast made to go to lunch.
I did mention that at the last meeting, so.
Anyway, other than thanking you for driving, I mean, there is a 12 evening and 12 midnight. It doesn't have to always be 7 in the morning.
I think that's a very good point, so.
I'll be back at any 12 p.m.
Okay.
Evening, not lunchtime, a.m., I guess.
Everybody's up in.
No, I think that it's fair. I mean, if I had to get up in the morning, they have to stay up late at night.
That's a good point. I'll run that by the county manager and see what he says.
I'm at
the chamber as well.
I'm asking you to take a vote on it.
Anyway. I don't think it's one of our vote. One thing we get to vote on.
I'm not going to say that. I have had some conversations with recently again. And I asked this board several months ago to put it back to mind and still would like you to think about it, because I'm going to come up one day and I'm going to ask you. We can do some type of an ordinance that will address the issue of puppy mills. But the county just had to deal with that issue. I know there's a lot of difference between who is breeding what. But if they're breeding more, they can sell, and these animals haven't been destroyed. We need to have some organization, like Johnny, the health department, look into having some type of ability to go in and just make sure these animals are being treated.
official follow-up on that. So, Sam's got a meeting coming up sometime in the 2 months. The committee's going to address some of that in that ring, recommendation or request to the sector on that behalf.
And I'm waiting on Sam to come.
Yeah.
That's what y'all have been talking. We all know that unless we address the issue of state immunity, we cannot address the unwanted population. But an unwanted population that is being addressed by the breeders who are breeding animals that can't sell them and adopting them on the county, so to speak, then there needs to be some type of ordinance developed where the health department, so to speak, can go by and see what is taking place. We don't need the incident like happened in Buffalo County this past week, and I know that it happened all over the state. Anybody would like me to send you videos of some of these, I'll be more than happy to do so. It will make you sick. And some of these animals have not even been out of cage and touched grass in their entire life. But anyway,
I'll echo Commissioner Hutchins said, I know that the task force that whenever you were chair that you formed and Commissioner Hutchins is on, working along with the animal control, they are working on some issues pertaining to your concerns. So I appreciate your leadership on getting that task force started.
It's a step in the right direction is that staying near the clinic that we're going to have through the animal control too. So that's going to help.
Mr. Allen?
I had an opportunity to attend the World War II D-Day celebration at the World War II Museum in New Orleans. And I was very impressed with what went on there. They recognized the veterans that attended that were still here from D-Day. There was a gentleman there that there was 144 of his counterparts that hit the sand in Normandy, and he was one of 14 that survived. So it was very heartwarming to see these guys up there. They introduced each one of them individually. It was probably about 25, 30, and said what they did, what served, and it was really cool. If you haven't ever been, you should go. They have about a 45 documentary that Tom Hanks does. It's a 4D, and you feel like that you're right there in the middle of it. And when they got to the scenes where there was snow, had snow flowing over you, and your seat vibrating, but it's well worth attending and going to.
That's several things. That came back to the library council meeting last week. Pretty successful. Ken may be not you anymore, even though we have a lot, but some of the councilmen there came by, didn't know him, we had the EMS base station, and then Joe gave us the bloodhound on prescriptions and follow-up and so forth, and really interested me. So that was a good meeting. Had a Board of Health meeting last week, pretty good. And also, Sam and I went down to Troy to meet the wildlife people on Gun Lake and look at one of the sites down there. We're planning another meeting on the 24th. Okay, yesterday, which was yesterday, Bill and I attended Enfield and Gaston County for ranking the projects. And one of the good things, I guess, is Bill and I talk about the bypass is not being ranked by local, it's state approved now. That they're ranking it, so the bypass is moving along real good. We had several, we got to get back again on Friday, several. One of them was the intersection out here on Marion 150, intersection at Jim Hoster, and there was a
Peach and Marion.
Yeah.
Oh, that's 150.
Yeah, and then there was Battle Rim Railroad Crossing at Kings Mountain was on the list. I think Waco Bridge is still there where it gets linked, no question. But I think that it was a good move when we kept pushing to join Gaston, Lincoln, and Cleveland MPO, okay? Because I told all of them, just look at one side, and I told them, but you know, when Gaston County ran it for years, did their own thing, it's going to take a few years for it to work into it. But in sitting around the table with those guys yesterday, they are very much interested in the region, regional planning, and that's what it's all about now. It's a plus for the three counties to go together, because before we were competing for the same pot, now we've got a little bigger pot, and we can spread it a little more on different things. There was several bike paths. I think we've got a improvement at the airport on it.
85 wide.
85 wide, and 85 wide, and the state to pick that up. That's going to be a major event from Belmont.
Three phases.
Yeah. Back this away, so it's been interesting. Like I said, we're going again on Friday.
Any other special thank you for that, John. Great job on that.
Because nobody else wants it.
You keep doing a good job, man.
You do so good, nobody else can.
If I can interject, I did talk with one of the state representatives yesterday on his birthday, and he was telling me, he brought up the MPO, brought up your name, and said that you have assumed a leadership role with that, and that you have made a world of difference up there. So your efforts are being known in
Robert. I think it boils slow on you, Robert.
I don't know. I'll tell you that's what they told me.
Follow up on some of the veterans issues. We just confirmed that regarding the World Series Sunday, August the 17th, is Military Appreciation Day, which is being sponsored by USAA, national organization. I think that shows the importance of that particular day. We've been participating. We've also just received confirmation that Medal of Honor recipient Bruce Crandall will be honored guest that day. We'll be participating in the ceremonies of the day. Very interesting guy. Look him up on the internet. Survived 600 missions in Vietnam. Very celebrated Medal of Honor recipient. So we're very excited about that day. Secondly, congratulations to Mickey on moving the chamber forward. I'm sure you feel better after today. It's a nice meeting, so congratulations there. Just a couple of nice notes locally. Ultra has, in speaking to Mr. Stewart, they are thrilled about getting a new contract, and also had an opportunity to visit Jaws of Life, which is getting ready to do some interesting things, hopefully, in partnership with the community college. Visited with them today, and also attended a few other meetings that most offices go to during the course of the 2-week period.
Anything for the son?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Hope you get a relay job, son.
Yeah.
I've just got a couple of quick things. One, just Commissioner Sumner, if you've been on your calendar, June 28th, Tractor Supply, 10 o'clock, from 10 until 2 o'clock. They will be taking the cash chamber out there from Animal Control Act out to Tractor Spot, and fundraiser. We'll have a fundraiser there. Public can come out. It's $5 to swing at it with a sledgehammer, or $10 to get you 3 swings at it with a sledgehammer. What's that? It's going to be on June 28th. That's a Saturday at 10 o'clock in the morning. It'll last till probably, I believe they've got on the calendar until 2. So if you want to swing by for a few minutes and swing it with the cash chamber, you can do that. So,
Roger has it. You know, managers get prepared for that. Work it in the mulch tomorrow.
Yeah, that's right. Bring you a little mulch.
April's out there waiting for something.
I think it's Jeff.
Oh, also, thank you. Cato, it's Thursday. Don't forget about that as well. You're down there. And since the last time we met, high school graduations, I think we've been proud of all of the young people in our county. Great graduation ceremonies, and I know it was tough for for all of us to get all of them, so, but we're very, very well represented by our younger generation. Speaking of our younger generation, we do have some young ladies that are in Raleigh right now, and competing for some titles. We've got Miss Shelby is there, and Miss Teen Shelby is there as well. And have you heard from Molly since she's been up there?
What do you mean by hearing? Yeah, they're up there involved in statewide competition. I think you'll want to follow that if you can, and you also can tune in, you can look on the internet and cast votes for Molly, and that helps in the calculation of her standing. Hopefully, Saturday, when the announcements are made, our first choice would be that she'll make the top 10, and that'll be announced, I think, Saturday morning. So we're excited about those two young ladies representing us. They're very nice, nice men.
Yeah, Molly and Rachel Mallory, the other two that are up there that they're competing right now. So keep them in your prayers. They're away from home, so nice to have them. Unless there's any other business for the county, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn. Motion and a second.